morning, everyone. Pleasure to have you with us this morning, those of you here present, and those of you who are joining us on live stream. Our call to worship. All the earth shall bow down before you, O God, shall sing to you, shall sing to your name, O Most High. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, as we gather round the table of the Lord to celebrate this Holy Eucharist, we take a moment to examine our conscience, asking God for forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Again, you call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father with your seat for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, give us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our time. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever.
Amen. A reading from the second book of Kings. In the 10th month of the 9th year of Zedekiah's reign, on the 10th day of the month, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and his whole army advanced against Jerusalem and camped around it and built a siege wall on every side. The siege of the city continued until the 11th year of Zedekiah. On the 9th day of the 4th month, when famine had gripped the city and the people had no more bread, the city walls were breached. Then the king and all the soldiers left the city by night through the gate between two walls that was near the king's garden. Since the Chaldeans had the city surrounded, they went in the direction of Arabah. But the Chaldean army pursued the king, overtook him in a desert near Jericho, abandoned by his whole army. The king was therefore arrested and brought to Riba, and the king of Babylon pronounced sentence on him. He had Zedekiah's son slain before his eyes. Then he blinded Zedekiah, bound him with fetters, and had him brought to Babylon. On the 7th day of the 5th month, there was the 9th year of Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon. Nebuchadnezzar, captain of the bodyguard, came to Jerusalem as a representative of the king of Babylon. He burned the house of the Lord, the palace of the king, and all the houses of Jerusalem. Every large building was destroyed by fire. Then the Chaldean troops, who were with the captain of the guard, tore down the walls that surround Jerusalem. Then Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, led into exile the last of the people remaining in the city. And those who had deserted to the king of Babylon and the last of the artisans. But some of the country's poor, the captain of the guard left behind as a vine dressers and farmers. The word of the Lord. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. By the streams of Babylon, we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. On the aspen of that land, we yearn our hearts. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. Though there were the captor ask of us the lyric of our songs, and our despoisers urge us to be joyous, sing for us the songs of Zion. Let my tongue be silenced if I ever forget you. How can we sing a song to the Lord in a foreign land? If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand be forgetting. Be silence if I ever forget. May my tongue cleave to my palate if I remember you not, if I place not Jerusalem ahead of my joy. Let my tongue be silence if I ever forget you.
When Jesus came down from the mountain, great crowds followed him. And then a leper approached, did him homage, and said, "Lord, if you wish, you can make me clean." He stretched out his hand, touched him, and said, "I will do it. Be made clean." His leprosy was cleansed immediately. Then Jesus said to him, "See that you tell no one, but go show yourself to the priest and offer the gift that Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A great crowd, or great crowds, followed Jesus. They're very much taken up by his preaching, by the message that he had to impart to the people, by the way he spoke. Constantly, the Gospels refer to the fact of the crowd's reaction to Jesus' teachings. They were amazed. Never had they heard anyone speak the way he did, so on and so forth. And yet, these same crowds were nowhere to be found when Jesus was crucified. One has to wonder to what extent Jesus had an impact in their lives. You know, the same goes for us. We gather around the table of the Lord. We listen to Jesus' word, Jesus speaking to us. I hope we are touched by it. But to what extent are we influenced by it? When we hear his word, does it have an impact in our lives? Does it change us? Are we left cold approaches Jesus. Now, we all know what leprosy was, especially at that time, in fact, up until our own days, because medication to control leprosy wasn't discovered until the 1930s, late 30s at that. And now, leprosy can be controlled. It's not healed, but it can be controlled. At the time of Jesus, there was no such thing as control. It was understood to be very contagious. That is why lepers were excluded from society, because of the contagion. At that time, and in many societies today, people lived very closely. Houses are not like our houses here in the States. In most of the world, where we have 5-6 bedrooms in our houses, several bathrooms, living room, dining room, kitchen, you know what I mean. We're talking of houses that have maybe one room, and you do everything in that one room. If you were fortunate, you might have two rooms. Never would you have 5, 6, or 7 rooms in a house, never. Unless, of course, you're wealthy, and then you could afford that. But we're talking of the majority of people at the time of Jesus. So, just to impress on us the fact that close living favored the spread of leprosy. And that is why lepers were excluded from society. Terrible, terrible way of life. They were not allowed to approach anyone who did not have the disease. And so this leper coming to Jesus knew that this was really a bold move on his part. Was it out of desperation? Was it out of the reality that he thought Jesus could do something for him? That Jesus could heal him? He comes over to Jesus. He pays him homage. That is to say, he recognizes Jesus' dignity. And he says to him, if you wish, you can heal me. You can make me clean. If you wish. It's saying to Jesus, you have the power. Now, the question is, are you willing to exercise that power on my behalf? You know, Jesus doesn't hesitate. You ask, of course he's willing to do it. Not only that, but he does something that he is not allowed to do in society, and that is to touch that leper. He stretches out his hand and he touches the leper, it says. It says, be made clean. Be made clean. Again, we are face to face with the power of words. Constantly, the Gospels zero in on the power of words. Here, once again, we have that. And his leprosy was cleansed immediately. You know, this same Jesus desires to be part of our lives also. Not only when we are experiencing problems or difficulties, such as this man here, but he desires to be part of our lives on a daily basis. Again, we have to invite him. We have to be open to his influence. And to invite Jesus in means that we have to be willing to allow him to change our lives. That's where the problem comes in. Because, my dear brothers and sisters, if we go down to the depths of our heart, we're very happy and comfortable with the way things are going. We don't want change. We don't want someone else influencing us on that level. So what does that mean for a relationship with the Lord Jesus? These are all points that are worthwhile thinking about, because they touch our lives personally. It's not enough to simply listen to his word. That word has to have an influence on us. Otherwise, it has no power. It has to change us. As we continue to celebrate the Holy Eucharist, let us ask the Lord Jesus, who comes to us in that sacrament, to effect that change in us that he desires. We come before the Lord, asking him to be part of our lives through the petition that we present.
For the church, that she may keep the celestial songs of the heavenly Jerusalem in her heart as she endures her times of persecution on earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the fall of the city of Jerusalem and the fate of her king may be a sober warning to any nation that abandons the law of God for immorality and wickedness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick in our hospitals and nursing homes, along with all those who are cared for in their homes, that the healing of Christ may give them patience, trust, hope, and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus, who promptly stretched out his hand to touch and cure the leper, may heal and console all those who have asked us to pray for them in their time of sickness or destitution. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Fern Mattson and Peter Sylvester and all those listed in our book of prayer intentions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For George Floyd, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We bring all these intentions under the paternal care of Mary as together we pray. O Mary, help of the sick, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you. You know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that, as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to the joy and feast after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, leading us through the cross, the joy of the resurrection. Amen.
And our offertory hymn will be Jesus, Remember Me. Jesus, Remember Me.
Jesus, we've been loving.
my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. In Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke, gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be both heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Let the kingdom, the power, and glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share a sign of that peace with one another. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Christ.
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Believe in the love God has for us. Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Pray to St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. The Mass is ended. Let us go and proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.
You have a wonderful day.
And our closing hymn is Holy God, We Praise Thy Name. Holy God, We Praise Thy Name.